This project take a real, real long time, like the Yangtze River flows. I guess in 2005, you had the first script. In 2012, it went to Hong Kong. And now, finally, we are really happy to have it here. Can you tell us about this long process of making this movie?
Let me attempt an answer. In 2005, the original idea came, but I didn't start off with the script at that point. I just got the idea. It came from my obsession with rivers and certain of my own romantic experiences. I traveled to the Yangtze River following that and had more ideas. I started writing the script in 2008. It took me 4 years. I finished in 2011. Yes, a slow process, but not too lonely, as we got support from Cannes, Rotterdam, France Sud, and the HAF from Hong Kong, as well as the Golden Horse Fund from Taiwan. A lot of investor support, which helped us to complete this long journey. But it's all been worth it to be sitting here today. Before working on this film, despite being Chinese, I didn't know very much about the Yangtze River. Just before we started, I was still talking about how green the waters were and how big the mountains were with the director. And I was very optimistic, but I found out that the water in some places has risen by 100 meters. Some lot of animal and plant species and buildings have been destroyed there. Now, in terms of many temples, what you see now is just a reconstruction or samples from them. And the Yangtze River dolphin used to be very common, but can now only be seen in a few specific places. There's very few of them left. For me, it's a source of shame, actually, to have been that ignorant about the Yangtze River. I was actually doing interviews this morning. A journalist asked me about my understanding of the relationship between the Yangtze River and time, because it's referred to as a river of time. Well, I get the sense that sometimes the Yangtze River has stopped, and sometimes it's actually flowing backwards because it's kind of artificially controlled now. It's not the Yangtze River that it was once. Working on this film was actually my first real experience with the Yangtze River as such. You know, I'd heard about it from when I was small, but didn't know much about it in reality, and that all changed when I actually got there. You know, people talk about people feeling solitude or loneliness by the sea, but this changed my perception. You feel small enough when you're by the sea, but you're completely unconscious of your own existence there. When you arrive at the Yangtze River, you really feel life and death, you feel these huge forces at work.
Now,
before we started, the director told me no smartphones, no iPads, no computers, just bring one mobile phone with you for contact purposes only.
Now,
I ended up feeling quite melancholy or even depressed, but I think that's what the Yangtze River does to you. It really draws you in. A total box office in China was 44 billion last year. That's very rapid growth. And the good thing about that is that the overall size of the market is bigger. Recent films by Jia Zhangke and also Black Ice can also find their audiences. Now, not everybody is going to be going to see CROSSCURRENT, but despite its more niche appeal in China, the Americas, or Europe, It's important that you have films like this present in the cinemas. A niche of a 44 billion box office market, like in the West, is still a significant market sector. So there is going to be a major space for artistic films in the future in China.